Premiere Pro has a lot of overlay options, and you can customize the overlay. What I'm showing on the screen right now is not an overlay that you would use for video production. It's more of a benchmark overlay. I'll hit play really quick, and you can tell it's giving stats more than information about the actual video clips in your timeline or sequence. The way you make this overlay appear is you hit Shift, Control, and F11. Now, on some of your keyboards, you might have to hit Shift, Control, F11, as well as the function key. It'll make the overlay appear, or it'll also make it disappear for you. Another type of overlay with Premiere Pro, which is what most of you want to use, is if I go over here and hit Overlays, now you can see it's information about your video files and your audio files. This particular overlay is playing back while I'm playing back the video. You can disable it during playback. If I go into overlay settings, we can switch things around. See custom overlays. You can do whatever you want. You can display source time code, or you can show markers, sequence clip name, project clip name. So if I select project clip name, we're gonna see it totally switches the information. That's really all there is to it. You have so many different options with the overlays when it comes to playing back using Premiere Pro. I'm gonna go into the settings again, and we can switch this around to file name. As you can see, we're switching all the parameters that you're seeing on the screen right now. If we want to, I can go into overlay settings. And let me switch to editing overlay, and let me just see how that's set up. So it's set up a little bit different. It's showing different information, and this one isn't being displayed during playback. We can switch that though. If we go to where there's more video layers, you're gonna see, you know, more information. So let me go into settings really quick. We can enable overlay during playback. You can enable overlays when you're using the Mercury Transmit. So if you're using third-party hardware from Blackmagic Design or AJA, and you want the overlay to be displayed on a professional AV monitor, Premiere Pro gives you that option. So I'll hit OK, and now you can see it's displayed during playback. It's pretty simple. I'll hit stop, and let me go over to overlay settings. And like I said, you have so many different options for all the different data that you'd want to show, you know, during playback. There's different options, as you can see, vertical, center alignment, you know, also top alignment, just all kinds of settings that you can switch. You can do the font size, the opacity or opacity, whichever you want to call it. And like I said, I can come in here and make any change that I want. I'll do project clip name. Why not? And now we see the project clip name. It's that easy to do the overlays. I want to say that if you are outputting to broadcast compliant hardware by using the Mercury Transmit, you might notice you need to make the fonts quite a bit bigger. I should let people know, if you go to the overlay settings, we can select source time code. Now, if we want to save this overlay, it's easy to do. We go back into overlay settings, and you just simply hit this save preset and name it. I'll just say test. Now you can see it's added to our custom overlays. Here I can go to video one overlay. Because with this particular overlay, it's only showing the information for video track one and audio track one, even if you have a bunch of layers. So that's what's really cool about using the overlays with Premiere Pro. You can customize them however you want. If you found this video helpful or informative, you might want to watch some of my other videos.